You are listening to the audio production of Out of the Dark, My Journey Through the Shadows to Find God's Joy by Mandisa, with Suzanne Gosselin and foreword by Natalie Grant, published by K-Love Books. This book is read by Zakiya Young. Dedication to Keisha. Foreword by Natalie Grant. My friendship with Mandisa goes back more than a decade now. From the moment we met, we shared an instant connection over our love for the same kind of music, soulful, big-voiced singers who inspired us as vocalists. It didn't take long to realize that we had a lot more in common than just our musical tastes. We are also women with strong personalities who have no problem speaking our minds. And through the years, we've also discovered we've faced similar battles. Our struggles may stem from different circumstances, but we have wrestled with the same things: fear, anxiety, and depression. My sweet friend and I have both come to realize that we are not alone. So many are battling similar dark emotions that rage in their hearts and minds. Mandisa's Out of the Dark is an honest account that will illuminate the truth that your mind and your heart are precious to Jesus. It will equip you with the knowledge that God is bigger than any circumstance you face. As you will soon experience, Mandisa's faith is infectious, and when she shares with you what is on her heart, you want to do all you can to be a part of her story. Her transparency is a constant invitation to draw near to Jesus. When she told me about her desperate desire to see her brother John come to know Jesus, I decided to join my faith with hers. Every day at 9 a.m., an alarm would go off on my phone, and the words, "Pray for John," would pop up on my screen. And that's exactly what I did each and every day. I prayed for John. You'll have to listen to this book to find out how God answered that prayer, but let's just say he did not disappoint. Again and again, I've witnessed Mandisa's willingness to play a part in someone else's healing, either physical or spiritual, regardless of the cost. In fact, I have never met anyone who champions others like she does. She is a cheerleader in the most genuine ways. In her moments of great success, she often turns the attention away from her talent to shine the spotlight on those around her. Her faithfulness in sharing her battle with depression is another example of her selfless love for others. Her openness and vulnerability in telling her story demonstrate her huge heart and confidence in the healing power of our God. Out of the Dark invites you into that story and shows the way to that healing. This book is not a quick fix. In fact, one of my favorite aspects of this story is that Mandisa is still on her journey. She doesn't have it all figured out. She openly invites us to peek into her life and is candid about how, as a follower of Jesus, you can believe the truth one day and wake up the next having fallen for another lie. By revealing her own struggles, she helps us see that God is the one who does the work and leads us to true and lasting freedom. We don't need a quick fix. We just need Jesus. Every moment, every day. And in each chapter, Mandisa leads us back to this truth. I know Out of the Dark will be a lifeline to those who, like us, have struggled with their mental health. She is not afraid to share the hard times she has walked through, and I am so very proud of my friend's courage and vulnerability. Wherever you find yourself on your life journey, in this book, you will find wisdom and practical advice to help you find contentment with who God made you to be, and the courage to take him at his word. I understand how lonely the dark is. My testimony, and the testimony Mandisa shares in this book, is that only the Lord can bring you out of that darkness. As Mandisa shares her low points from her journey in the dark, it becomes evident that she trusts the Lord to be her light. We want Him to be your light too. And I believe Mandisa, through her bravery and transparency, will serve as a guide, showing many the way out of the dark. Chapter 1. Overcomer. You're an overcomer. Stay in the fight till the final round. You're not going under, because God is holding you right now. You might be down for a moment, feeling like it's hopeless. That's when He reminds you that you're an overcomer. I cracked the door to the bedroom open and entered the dimly lit room. A day earlier, my friend's husband, Briones, had texted me. "We've called in hospice. You'd better come see Keisha as soon as you can." My beautiful friend, hairstylist, and former background singer had been in the fight of her life against breast cancer for a year and a half. Now, with the palliative nurse on hand to make Keisha more comfortable, it seemed she wasn't going to win the fight. I couldn't bring myself to believe it. I had learned of her illness on a chilly January afternoon. Our scheduled hair appointment began as it had for over a decade. I sat in the salon chair with the towel and protective cape around my neck as Keisha worked her magic on my new growth. The smell of chemical relaxer filled the air, and the sound of Wayne Brady giving away a vacation on Let's Make a Deal was drowned out by our conversation. Now that Keisha no longer traveled with me, we relished these hours when we could hash out the latest details of our days. I would catch her up on road life, the latest album I was recording, and any male suitors I had my eye on. She would talk about church, gush about Briannis or their son BJ, and fill me in on her recent gigs. That day, though, the appointment ended differently than past visits. She told her next client, who was already sitting in the extra chair in her room, that she needed an extra minute with me. She pulled me outside. Sensing that something was off, I furrowed my brow. "What's wrong?" I asked anxiously. I didn't expect Keisha's next words. "I'm pregnant," she said, flashing a beaming smile. My jaw dropped and I squealed with excitement. BJ was about to turn 10 and Keisha was in her late 30s, so this news was an answer to my friend's prayers for another child. I had hundreds of questions, but they could wait. All I wanted was to celebrate with my friend and pray for the little baby growing inside. I laid my hand on her belly, ready to pray right then, but she stopped me before I could bow my head. "Wait," she said in a way that made my stomach tighten. "There's something else I need you to pray for. I found a lump in my breast." A few weeks later, Keisha received her official diagnosis of stage 3 breast cancer. When she called me with the news, I immediately went into fight and fix mode. I knew she had a battle in front of her, but she would get through this. I was 100% sure God would heal Keisha. Why wouldn't He? She had a young family that needed her. She was a bright light in so many lives. Countless people were praying in faith for her healing, and a full recovery would bring God so much glory. Because she was pregnant, Keisha chose a less aggressive form of chemotherapy to protect her developing child. Her cancer was already advanced, but for Keisha, threatening the life of her baby wasn't even a choice. She would do whatever it took to keep him safe. And on June 8, 2013, Brennan Michael Mitchell was born perfect and healthy. When Keisha texted me the picture of her beautiful, chunky chocolate baby, tears welled up in my eyes, and my heart rejoiced for my friend. I marveled at her grace and strength. Her top prayer request during her pregnancy had been for God to protect the child in her womb as she battled the disease threatening both of their lives. Brennan's birth was an incredible answer to prayer, and fresh hope rose in my heart. Now that Brennan had been born, Keisha could step up her cancer treatment. The worst was behind her, I thought. Soul Sisters. I first met Lakeisha Mitchell when I was a college student at Fisk University. I attended Greater Grace Temple Community Church, where her husband was the pastor. At Greater Grace, as is the case in many Black churches, the pastor's wife is referred to.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.